Hello everybody, this is Tiziano and today we're gonna put our hands on the RC Benchmark Thrust Stand Model 1585. Most of you probably already know RC Benchmark for their 1520 thrust stand that came up a few years ago, but this 1585 comes a long way with better electronics, better load cells, and the ability to measure the torque. Now you might ask, why would I need to measure the torque? Well, for example, if you multiply the torque by the rate of rotation of your motor, you have the mechanical power. And then you can compare the mechanical power with the electrical power for having a better estimation of your plant efficiency. Plus, you can also have a better estimate of how much torque your motor plus propeller generates, so you know how much yaw control on your multirotor you have, or how much torque you have to compensate on your airplane. And for all of my viewers, that is a time-limited offer, and you can redeem your discount code by clicking on the link in the description below or using the code at the checkout. In this way, you can sustain the channel and save some money. Now, this stand is perfect for anything that goes from a mini racer to a giant quadcopter. Now, for something that is really massive, they also have some dedicated thrust stand for higher loads and also for counter-rotating props. But this is okay for anything that can push up to 5 kilograms of thrust, that is about 11 pounds, and can measure up to 1.5 newton meters, that is approximately 13 pounds inch. I did the math. But besides the stand itself, their control app is amazing, because not only you have the ability of manually setting your PWM, or you can also interface with D-Shot communication with some additional elements, you also have the ability of writing your own automated script. And for that, you can either use your own imagination or starting from one of the examples that they already provide. And in the end, I'm gonna show you a hidden pearl, the ability of connecting to the app using a UDP connection, meaning that you can interface your software to the Air app just using UDP and extend the ability of their app using your own imagination. Now, back to the thrust stand. The 1585 came together with the optical probe sensor over here and the no solder mount board over here. It's very useful for rapidly swapping motors, because rather than using bullet connectors or solder, you can just plug the connectors in these screw terminals for a rapid motor swap. I didn't use this board for the sake of the video, but I really appreciated the optical probe sensor. As you can see over here, there is an electrical probe sensor where you can that can measure the RPM using one of the electrical signals. It's not as reliable as the optical probe, so I really recommend going for the optical probe. Everything is really easy to set up. It took me not a long time to mount the kit, and the instructions are very clear. But before you mount the motor to the stand, be sure that you calibrate the stand using the 200 grams weight that is provided in the box. And I'm saying that because this 200 grams weight goes exactly where you would mount your motor. So before you mount the motor, be sure you calibrate it. And for calibrating, it's pretty easy. You have to mount it vertically using a clamp. So you clamp it vertically like that, and you use the weight for calibrating this load cell over here. Then you will be mounting the thrust stand horizontally, clamp it down to a table, and use the arm for calibrating the torque cells. And then you're ready to go. But wait, before you do any experiments, be sure that you follow my advices. First, this is no toy, and at all time when you test it, use safety goggles and stay as far away from it as possible. Second, if you want to touch it, be sure to unplug the battery or the power source. Third, mount the propeller as a pusher and not a puller. In this way, you're not gonna have the airflow disrupted by the thrust stand. You're gonna have much better results. And fourth, be sure that you give the airflow as much space as possible. Don't stay close to walls. Better, for example, if you had a garage that you can open the garage door and let the airflow go outside, so you don't have any ground effect in your measurements. Now that said, let's dive into the app and start doing some tasks with this awesome truss stand. Power goes right here and the ESC plugs right here on top. The ESC control comes from this servo plug over on the top. On the top, you notice that there are four terminals, one for the ESC and three for servos. Yes, because you can also plug servos and have normal servos in your test. And this comes very in handy, for example, if servos are part of your power plant or you have control vanes, so they can be in your measurements. Remember that the servo number one is already taken by the optical probe. This is the RC Benchmark Dynamometer app. In the setup tab, you can configure your unit of measures, for example, the torque in newton meters, I set the thrust in grams, the motor speed in RPM, temperature in Celsius. On the top right, you can set up the RPM sensor, so how many white piece of tapes you put on the motor. In my case, I only set one. On the right side, you have the good settings, and here you can activate the experimental scripting mode. The experimental scripting mode is what you need if you want to have automated test scripts, and that's what we're going to see in a few minutes. The debug mode is something that I don't recommend you check out because it will slow down the reading of your sensor. Basically, this is mostly for debugging, so you want to uncheck this one. In a safety cutoff, you can set the minimum maximum voltage for your battery, for example, so you don't accidentally run out of juice or you don't destroy your battery. The maximum current, maximum power. Now let's go to the manual control. We have the ability to control three servos, but remember that we have the optical probe connected to servo one, so we cannot use servo one. We have the ESC, so we can check this ESC bar over here, and immediately you hear that the ESC has been activated. In order to make it a little more interesting, let's also check the thrust and the RPM. And as you see, as soon as I hit the thrust button, I already have a thrust of 28 grams. Now, this is because you need to tear your load cells, and that's exactly what happens if I hit the push button on the left, tear load cell. In fact, if I hit it, the thrust goes to zero. And here we go. There it is. The motor is spinning at 3,350 RPM. And you see that the electrical probe and the optical probe are almost on the same spot, even though the electrical probe is a little bit more noisy. And the thrust is stable about 150 gram. Now, let me stop this. Here on the top, here you can immediately notice how noisy the electrical probe sensor becomes at low RPM and when you slow down the motor. And I can hit this continuous recording. Let's see what happens. So I hit continuous recording. It's saving data in this CSV file. And let me go ahead with the slide bar. Awesome. Okay, there it is. That's the CSV file. Now I open it with Notepad, but you can open it with whatever software you want, like Excel. As you can see, everything has been logged. There is an entry, and on the left there is the time, and then I have one column for the signal, the servos, accelerometer, torque, thrust, voltage, current, electrical and mechanical power, and so on and so forth. So you can really go through the time domain and see how the thrust and the torque had changed during your test. Now, rather than doing it manually, there is a much more convenient way to automate your test, and this is with automatic control. In the automatic control tab, you can go on the top here where there is script, you open this drop down menu, and you see there are stock scripts that you can start from. One of the most useful of all is this sweep discrete, probably the one that you're going to use the most. So the sweep discrete, as you see, it's a script that starts from a PWM of 1000 and goes up to a PWM of 1400 in four steps. It waits 3 seconds to stabilize, and then it records 20 samples, and then it averages among all of the 20 samples, and it saves that result into a CSV file. Let's change this script. So how can I do it? I can't change anything. This is a read-only file, so I just copy everything, and then I go up here and I create a new custom script, and then I control V. There it is. Now I can go up and I can change this minimum value to 1200 and the maximum value to 1500, for example. And I do, six steps. Okay, I hit the run button and start. It waits 4 seconds to settle, it tears the load cell, and then it starts. Step 0, step 1, step 2 at 1300. Let me open also the ESC power. Much more. There it is. Look at the power. We have both the electrical power and the mechanical power. If we open the CSV file in an Excel spreadsheet, we can have a much better view of all the results. In fact, I can also plot the thrust column against the motor optical speed, and here is the results. In fact, you see the RPM on the x-axis and the thrust on the y-axis. And as you can see, the data lay on a second order polynomial curve. And let's actually verify this. If I select the data, I can plot a trend line. And as you can see, a linear trend line does not do a good job in fitting the data. But if I select a polynomial over here, very nice, I have a good fit. Now that we saw how you can manually control the stand or how can you create automated test scripts, let's reveal the hidden pearl. The fact you can control the app using UDP. And this is great for a nerd like me because it gives me freedom to create my own software. If you want to control the app using the UDP, you can just start from this a network UDP script, and you can customize the script using your actual IP address. In my case, I already did it, and I created this UDP client sample.js. So on the other side, I need to receive the UDP packet and parse a JSON message. On the other side, let's open Packet Sender. Now, if you don't see any communication over here, first of all, check out your UDP port, but most likely if you don't receive any communication, it's due to the firewall. So you see in my case, I have all the telemetry coming from the app as a JSON format string. I can send a command from Packet Sender itself. For example, let's try and send 1300. If I send 1300, I hit send, there it is. You see the console says I received a 1300 packet and the ESC goes to 1300 PWM. Now, this is all nice and good, but I created a Python script so to make the things a little bit more interesting. I already created a Python script. I create a socket, a read and write socket, and I define a function send PWM, and I also define a read data function. This read data function receives from the socket read, and because the string is a JSON format, I use JSON for converting the input string into a dictionary. Then I also create a while loop for continuously receiving and reading data. Then I use threading for launching the read UDP main, and now we define the main script. So here I print starting test, and then for every PWM element in this PWM start array, I send the value, I sleep, and then I print trust and RPM. And this trust and RPM, they have been constantly received by the read UDP main thread that runs over here. Now let's run the script, sending 1000, and you see the motor is doing. Okay, that was really exciting. Thank you guys for sticking up to the end of this video, and remember to redeem your discount code by clicking on the link in the description below. In this way, you save money and you sustain the channel. Thank you, RC Benchmark, for this amazing Trust 10, and I'll see you guys next time.